Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss the tedious features about Tally ERP 9 software. For the purpose of activating the tedious feature, you have to press F11 from your keyboard or just select features option from your right hand side. Here you have to select statutory and taxation option. From statutory and taxation option, here you will find that enable tax deducted at source. Just press yes here. Set alter tedious detail. Here you will press yes here. Here you have to write your TAN number, TAN registration number. Here you have to write your TAN number. Here you have to write deductor type. Here you have to write deductor branch or division detail. Here you have to write the person responsible detail. So the person responsible detail, here you have to write his name, father name, designation, PAN number, his address, city name, mobile number, telephone number, add extra. Now here you have to select whether if PAN is not available, then what is the rate of deduction for TDS. So in income tax, generally the rate of TDS is 20% if PAN is not available. Here ignore IT exemption limit for TDS deduction. If you are selecting here yes, then it will ignore the IT exemption limit for particular TDS item. However, I am selecting here no, so it will consider the IT exemption item. So in this way, I can configure my TDS features in my Tally. Now I have already created certain ledger. I will show you under the accounting info. Under the ledger, I am selecting here alter. I have created the ledger for my TDS. So TDS on 194C. So it will come under the head duty and taxes. Here the list of the duty will appear, so I have to select TDS. Here I have to select the nature of payment. If the nature of payment is not created, then you can create by pressing new category. As and when you press new category, you will find TDS nature of payment alteration or secondary window. So I am selecting here 194C. If I am selecting new category, you will have to write here name, section code, payment code, rate of TDS as well as the exemption limit. So I will show you what I have prepared 194C. The 194C contract under section 194C, payment code is this, remittance code is this, rate is 1% and the exemption limit 1 lakh I have created. So up to 1 lakh there will be the no TDS deduction in our case. So in this way I have created TDS ledger. I have created another ledger, TDS on 94G, under the duty and taxes. This is list of duty. I have to select a TDS. I have to create category, to which I have already created 194J. So 194J under which the rate is 10%. Here I have not write TDS exemption limit, so it will deduct TDS from first bill without any limit. If you have write here exemption limit 30,000, then it will deduct TDS as and when it cross the limit of 30,000. Now I am writing here TDS on commission, which is already created under the head duty and taxes. Under TDS duty 194H category, we have already created the threshold limit is 50,000 and rate is 5%. So in this way you can create the TDS category as well as TDS ledger. Now I am creating or altering my taxes expense ledger. So this is my professional charges under the head indirect expense. If TDS is applicable, I have to select here applicable, otherwise I will select not applicable. After which you have to select the category you have already created. So I have to select my category. So this is 194J. Save. Now another expense, freight expense, under the head indirect expense. I have to select TDS applicable. I have to select the nature of category. Yes. And just press enter. Your ledger will be saved. Now another ledger, commission expense. Under the head indirect expense, whether TDS is applicable or not, you have to select whether nature of payment. So nature of payment is my, from the list of nature of payment, I have selecting here 194H. Now you have to create your criteria ledger. So under criteria ledger, I have already prepared one of the my criteria ledger ABCN company. Under the sundry creditor TDS is applicable, so I have selected yes. I have to select the deducted type from my creditors. So this is the default deducted type as per the income tax. So I have to select particular deducted type as appear. Here you have to select deduct TDS in the same voucher. So I am selecting yes. If you are selecting that no, then it will not deduct TDS in the same voucher. Now here you have to write the PAN number of your creditor. After writing PAN number, you have to press here yes, provide PAN detail. So this is PAN effective date and this is the name as per PAN you have to select. Now again, another creditor ABC Transport, TDS is applicable, I am selecting yes. Deducted type individual or HUF, deduct TDS in the same voucher, I have writing here PAN number, provide PAN detail, I am making yes. Now one more ledger is there, Mr. Y, under the head sundry creditor TDS is applicable, he is individual as well as HUF, deduct TDS in the same voucher, I am pressing yes. Now here his PAN is not available. If PAN is not available, 20% TDS is applicable. So I am not writing here PAN. Here provide PAN detail, I am pressing yes, and here I have to select not applicable. So I am selecting not applicable and just pressing enter. Now I am making the entry in my Tally ERP 9 software. So first entry, commission is payable to Mr. Y rupees 60,000. So what is the entry? Commission account debit 60,000. To whom it is payable? Mr. Y. Now on commission we have written that TDS is applicable 5%. On commission TDS is applicable 5% and limit is 15,000. However, the Mr. Y is not having the PAN, so TDS is deducted 20%. If no PAN, then TDS is deducted 20%. So here you will find that as and when I have pressed enter on Mr. Y, the amount is already coming after deducting 20%. Here I have to write TDS in on commission 12,000. So in this way you can automate your TDS calculation in your Tally ERP 9 software. Now again I am making second transaction, freight need to be payable to ABC Transport rupees 27,000. So I am entering freight account debit 27,000, ABC Transport account debit 27,000. Now here the limit is 1,00,000 rupees. So as limit is not crossed and I have already written under the limit under category 194C. Under 194C, I have already written 1,00,000 exemption limit, so it will not deduct TDS and it will allow you to make entry. Now suppose I am making another entry, freight need to pay to ABC and Transport 78,000. So freight account debit 78,000, ABC Transport account, here you will find that out of 78,000, 1% is already deducted, because 78,000 plus 27,000, the 1,00,000 limit is already crossed, so it will deducting 1% TDS automatically. Now here you have to write 194C TDS ledger. Now as and when you press enter, you will be find one message, TDS is not deducted on the previous bill for ABC Transport. Do you want to deduct TDS now? If you are pressing no, then it will save the entry and no TDS deducted for your previous entry. But if you are pressing yes, this entry is saved and you will find another entry. As and when you select particular into your previous box, you will find this entry, accounting voucher creation for your TDS for your previous bill of ABC Transport, automatically done. You just have to save this entry. Now your TDS entry is done. So in this way you can automate the TDS calculation. Now I am making the another entry, bill is received from ABC and company for professional charges rupees 15,000. So professional charges account debit 15,000 through ABC and company. Now under the professional charges, I have created the nature of payment 194J. Under 194J, I have not written my exemption limit. So as my exemption limit is not written, so it will deduct TDS from my first bill. So as and when I press enter on ABC and company, it will deduct the TDS at per prescribed rate. So it will deduct the TDS at 10%. Now I am writing here TDS on 194J. Now I am making another entry, professional bill received from ABC and company 25,000. So professional charges 25,000. As and when I press ABC and company, it will deduct 10% TDS. Now I am here entering TDS on 94J. So in this way, you can make an entry of your TDS automatically. You can also see the statutory report of TDS by pressing on display menu. Here you have to select statutory report. From statutory report, you have to select TDS. Here you can select TDS outstanding. As and when I press TDS outstanding, this is my TDS outstanding coming up. You can select your particular period. So my outstanding for a particular section is this, total pending is this. You can also see your 26Q. So I am selecting here 26Q. So this is my 26Q. TDS deducted at a normal rate is this, and TDS deducted at a higher rate because PAN is not available is this. Now you can also create the payment from this window. So I am creating payment, state payment. Just select on the state payment. You will be asked to make a payment. Just select here TDS. Here you can write your particular month. So I am writing my particular month. Here I have to select particular section for which I am making payment. Otherwise here I have to create my all the item if you are making one payment for all my TDS. So nature of deduction, I am selecting all the item. Deduct the status, I am selecting here all. Now here I have to create ledger for my bank account. So I am creating my bank ledger under the bank accounts. So I have created my bank ledger. I have to select bank. As and when I select all the item, you will find that my TDS payment entry is done automatically. You just save this entry. Here you have to write the check number at extra and just save the entry. Now you will find that payment detail here, the included transaction is 0 but not included transaction is 1. Just press on it. Here you will find that bank detail are not available in payment voucher. So just select on this and you can reconcile your TDS transaction. So I am reconcile my transaction. Here I have to write my check number. Here I have to write my check date. Here I have to write my BSR code. Here I have to write my challan number. In this way I can reconcile my all the challan. Now under the third challan I am writing here. As and when I press enter, you will find that the summary of exception is 0. Now you will find that included transaction under the payment option is 1 and not included is 0. Now you will find that under form 26Q, this is my TDS deduction liability and this is my TDS paid and balance payable is 0. So in this way, you can make the entry of your TDS transaction in Tally ERP 9 software. Now you can see your TDS outstanding. So my TDS outstanding is 0 because I have already passed the entry for my payment. You can also see the ledger without PAN. Just select on a ledger without PAN. You will find that the Mr. Y individual or HUF has no PAN number is available. So we have deducted 20% TDS. So in this way you can make configure TDS in Tally ERP 9. Thank you.